director of Moonfalls Productions, and we're here right now in Nelson.
So I'm Monica Hepburn, I'm also from Vancouver. I have been working this past couple weeks with Mutya Macatumpag here at Oxygen Arts, and we're creating a multidisciplinary piece. The piece is called Spectacle of the Lost Self. It will be a focus on like our own inner landscapes, but also just kind of creating a piece that's accessible to other people, and just kind of like the overarching universality of just the darker places that exist within all of us.
In the beginning, it was kind of like, how do we mix our disciplines and how do we have them overlap so that they kind of make sense to each other? And so looking pretty much at like our strengths, we decided that we were going to mix it with a bit of theater, dance, a little bit of film, some visual arts, and like some stop motion animation. And so the piece we're working on is basically a deeper look into ourselves. So we're kind of taking a really vulnerable stance, and like not necessarily taking like an abstract or literal view on like kind of ourselves in our darker spaces, but we're looking at it as a source for the material that we're wanting to kind of create and share, which is what we don't really totally know right now. Like right now, I kind of decided that I was going to work on using some yarn. So what I wanted to do was really kind of look at the intricacies of like my life and like the patterns of my life in a seamless interweave. And so that's why I started kind of developing all of this yarn work here, which is going to be incredibly balanced in a way that you won't really know where things begin and end. That's the kind of feeling I wanted to have, kind of like representing our life patterns. And and all the little end bits are going to be obviously snipped off so that it doesn't show you the rawness of it. Work on our ancestors, like where's our ancestry from? And I'm like, fuck that, we're like been connected to our ancestry for a long while. Let's look at something different. Let's actually look at the stuff that we don't really talk about, which is depression. We didn't want to use the word depression because we felt like it's a really loaded word for a lot of people and for ourselves as well. So that's what we call the spectacle of the lost self, because we're always wandering, figuring out who we are as individuals. And and I bet everyone can relate to that, because we all feel alone at some point, or feel
feel disconnected, I guess.
Yeah, we feel disconnected from who we are. So we're trying to find that connection, we're trying to take a deeper look into that, what that connection is, what those connections are. And
I guess it came from that place of wanting to kind of, like you said, we were talking about doing a piece that related to ancestry, and just nothing was really like, we weren't generating a lot of ideas with that, and we're kind of sitting with that. And then I think we kind of both came to a place where we're like, well, maybe that's not what this is supposed to be about. And then when we started talking about this, it kind of cemented, and we started generating a lot of different ideas around the topics. To consider and how they're going to piece together and how there's going to be continuity in the piece, and also really wanting to like for the quality to be good. And that's like, it's easier if like you zone in on one thing and then that's sort of the focus for life or for a period of time, and so it's challenging to kind of be like have varied interests and to want it to still come together nicely in a limited time.
Yeah, and like for me being like a multidisciplinary artist for myself, it's like the longest thing, like for me, like throughout the journey of like my artistic practices, it's always been challenging to like believe like that, okay, that all of these things can like exist on one stage. But more and more as like I see like other artists, everyone is kind of not just focusing on one thing, but bringing like a whole bunch of elements together. And for me, like that's the only way I can really tell my story. So it's to bring all the elements of the things that I'm really passionate about. And it's not always an easy path, because I always think that, oh yeah, as an artist, I need to like just focus on like one thing, you know, focus on the one thing and like do it very well. However, it's about doing all those things and doing it all really well and bringing them onto the same stage so that it can connect to all different kinds of people and all different kinds of artists. We already know kind of what the theme is, so we just go away and let like whatever it is that's meant to inspire us in the moment inspire us, and then we come back. Or we talk and we talk about some of the things that we have. Because sometimes we'll be talking about something and we'll have like a flash or like a vision, and then we usually share it with each other, and pretty much from that point we try to kind of find a way to like materialize it in this moment. So
yeah, I mean, there is a lot of sort of, like Mutya said, the going off to our corners. I'm over there working, doing like stop motion stuff. Mutya will be like maybe dancing or playing music or whatever. So there is kind of this solitary within the collaboration, but then we're supporting each other just with, Mutya's sort of better with computers and technology and stuff. So she's really been supportive in helping me bring the images onto the computer, that kind of thing. And also, like, another example of how we collaborate is, like, Mutya will have a vision of something, like a really neat kind of visual idea, and then, like, I'll bring that to life. So there's kind of both of our creativity is kind of being used in the process, and it's like kind of becomes one thing. And then there will just be sort of overlap in we're still figuring out what the final piece is going to look like, but there's going to be, like, it's going to be woven together. So
come check out Spectacle of a Lost Self. The 23rd is going to be an open dress rehearsal. You can come check it out. It's going to be from 7:30 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. Here at Oxygen Arts. And then obviously August 25th. Come and check out the show. And there's going to be a Q&A afterward if you want to ask us any questions that might rattle our brains. It'd be awesome to see you there.